moderator for the annual Winter 2013 5th Grade Great Debate. The first debate issue is, should Alexandria City Public Schools continue to use the new standards-based grading system and report card? You'll hear the word standards-based a lot. It simply means what a student should know and be able to do according to the law of Virginia. We are debating this issue because some people like the new system. It is easy to understand, informative, and encourages students to work towards achieving a goal. However, others believe that it's confusing, scoring is subjective, and because the target score is only 3. Before you decide, listen to both sides of the argument. As you listen to each speaker, please complete the evaluation form that you've been given. Please put a check mark in the box that best represents the quality and presentation of each speaker. The winning team will be judged on how strong the argument is, not on whether you agree or not with the issue. Let's begin.
The new standards-based grading system is better than the former one because it is easier to understand. The new system tells you if you're advanced, proficient, basic, or developing with additional information. For example, if you are developing, it will say, needs a lot of support to be able to do work on your own. Two examples from teachers using the new system are, one, Carol Ann Tomlinson wrote an article called Educational Leadership, and she said, I certainly have come to understand what I'm teaching better, and I certainly have come to understand what I teach more fully. That quote tells me that teachers around Virginia understand the new grading system. Two, Patricia Scrifney wrote an article called 7 Reasons for Standards-Based Grading. She said that teachers can organize their curriculum in ways that are easy to understand and manage for. All of that gives me proof that the new standards grading system is easy to understand.
Why do I come to school? I come to school to prepare for high school and college.
Education is a pyramid, and elementary school is the foundation of the pyramid. What good does it do me to be graded using this new system if later on in my life I'll be graded on another? My school should be getting me ready for the future and how the future judges my performance. Students and teachers are unaccustomed to the new system. It would have been less confusing to have had a number to letter conversion scale for at least 2 quarters. According to the Washington Post, Alexandria officials have warned parents not to match the numbers with letter grade. Even if this had happened, how useful would the system be if you were judged on the old system when you move to middle school, high school, or move to a different state? Until the entire USA is on the system, it does not give an equal measure to your performance from school to school. Why would you rush changes to grading when you don't rush education? Thank you.
My team wants to keep the progress report because it provides information with students and parents with more specific information about what a child knows and can do in each of the content areas. Since the report card lists each standard that students are required to learn in each quarter, students will know what help is required to learn in each quarter. Students may need particular areas to work on, and students and their parents will know how they achieved in very specific areas. For example, in math, during the first quarter, students are expected to learn about polygons and geometric lines. A student receiving a score of 2 in this area and 3 in other areas for the quarter would now know where they are in the weakest and ways they need a comment. Now, that is a lot more information than our old report card.
ACPS should not continue to use the new standards-based grading system because the scoring is subjective and based on teachers' opinions. Subjective means judgmental or opinionated. Instead of giving teachers a clear grading system, ACPS has given them confusing guidelines that force teachers to make up their own scale. The teachers have to personally decide students' grades based on their opinions. According to an article in the Washington Post, The advanced rating is supposed to be reserved for students who demonstrate advanced understanding of key knowledge and skills, consistently applying them independently. What does that even mean? Once again, teachers must decide for themselves. That says that teachers must make up their own grades. This grading system is neither clear nor fair to teachers and students and parents. That is why ACPS should not continue to use the standards-based grading system. Thank you.
I can guarantee you that this new grading system will be great for the ACPS. This new grading system can push students to go the extra mile and receive a 4, since a 4 is proving that they have advanced knowledge of the subject. According to a 5th grade teacher in Northwest Arkansas, my students have pushed themselves to really put in the extra effort to get a 4, and most of them got 4s. That means that her students are doing more than they're asked to and achieving 4s. This new grading system is also great for students who love being creative, because creativity is also part of getting a 4. So say in science you're studying volcanoes, and your homework is a worksheet on volcanoes. But you don't just do the worksheet, you also make a paper mache volcano and bring it to school. That type of stuff can get you a 4. Ask yourselves, should grades be based on how you've put in great effort this quarter, or what you've achieved this quarter, or just an average put together of all your papers? Think about that.
The new number system is confusing and based off of the teacher's judgment, but the worst thing that ACPS has done, a 3 is proficient, or a good understanding of key knowledge. To me, I think of that as an average. Who would want to be average? Sometimes children expect a little bit too much out of themselves. Joy in the classroom has been replaced by fear, says one teacher from an elementary school in Kentucky. When kids get a 3, it may lower their self-esteem or happiness. 4 should be given to the students that really tried their best. Rather, 4s are given to students with an advanced understanding of key knowledge. Gwen Carol Holmes, our chief officer for City Public Schools, says it is amazing how well kids are hitting the target. But kids are only going to target and stopping. They think there is no point in going on. Why would you try so hard when you have nothing in return?
Disagrees with the con argument for a number of reasons. We know that the new grading system could be perfect for ACPS. First, we disagree with their argument that ACPS is a 3 is average. It's not. A 3 is proficient, and according to the Webster's Dictionary, a 3 is proficient means highly competent, skilled, or adept. So, ACPS wants us to be skilled. For instance, I got a lot of 3s in math last quarter. So I was skilled in math. Secondly, the argument that teachers score subjectively with standards-based grading is untrue. Teachers are trained professionals with a job that helps kids learn. According to an ACPS article, teachers use multiple data points, such as classroom tests, transfer tasks, progress monitoring assessments, criteria reference tests, classroom performances, etc., to determine where a child is. They wouldn't give a 4 to a student with a poor grade, would they? The final argument that we are unaccustomed to the new system is simple to fix. Once everybody adapts to the change, they will love this system. It's only a matter of time until we get used to it. After all, had ABCDF just been introduced, we'd be confused. Fairfax County Public Schools, another local school system, uses the standards-based grading because the new system aligns info they provide to parents with what they teach in the classroom. Some people love the new system, while others don't. But only some people supported integrating our schools. There were heated disputes over both issues, but it turned out being a great thing. Our new grading system will be too.
Our team believes that the new standards-based grading system has made a negative impact on our school and education. It confuses people and was implemented very poorly. It was put into action too quickly, and almost all students, parents, and even teachers are having a hard time adapting to it. The new grading system is very difficult to understand. It doesn't relate to the old system at all, so it's sometimes very difficult to understand exactly what the scores mean. It's also very unclear on how to get a 4. Do you need to do something extra, or you just have to do perfect on everything? In fact, the system is so unclear that our parent-teacher conferences had to be extended by 15 minutes just so that the teachers could explain the system to parents rather than talking about their child. The teachers don't just suddenly know what a student needs to work on because of this grading system. They could do that before by looking at a student's test scores, quizzes, and homework. Since some teachers have higher expectations than others, depending on their judgment, students could get higher or lower scores than they deserve. The new standards-based grading system does not encourage students to do their best. Some teachers were not allowed to give out 4s while others were. This is very inconsistent, and it makes students wonder if they actually deserve the grade they got. So ask yourself, is this new grading system really helping us on pushing us to do our best, or is it making it more difficult to understand how our education works? It's important to understand how well we have done in academics, and to do this, our team believes that we should stop using the new standards-based grading system.
The standard-based grading system has made a positive change in elementary schools. First of all, it gives a more specific understanding of what level the student is on. For example, a 95% is about a 3 with the standard-based grading system and an A with traditional. Now, an 105% would be a 4 with the standard-based because the student is going above and beyond to get those 5 extra points, but it's also an A with traditional. Students need a grading system that is specific on if they are proficient or advanced. Secondly, according to an ACPS article, standard-based grading systems gives the specific areas that the students need to work on. For example, with the traditional grading system, it will have maybe math in a box, and then next to it, it will have a letter grade. But with the standard-based grading system, it will have maybe dividing fractions or adding fractions and a number grade next to it. It gives the specific areas they need to work on. Thirdly, it pushes students to go above and beyond. Since it is hard to achieve a 4, it challenges the students. For example, one quarter, I got straight A's, and that was as far as I could go with traditional. But then the next quarter, I got all 3's, and I really wanted to improve for the first time ever. And also, with the traditional grading system, it doesn't push students hard enough because if they go above and beyond, they're going to get the same grade as a student that does proficiently. When I first realized this grading system, I didn't support it. But when I researched, I realized there were a lot of great things about it.
The new standards-based grading system should not continue because it does not provide students a clear target. For example, one reason ACPS should not continue to use the new standards-based grading system is because the new grading system wasn't explained thoroughly and parents and students were puzzled. According to an article in the Washington Post, a confused parent named Mary Ridley White says, "The way it's been presented, we are striving for average. We want to know how to help our kids strive for excellence." ACPS shouldn't continue to use the new grading system because the grading is unhelpful. Dr. Gwen Carroll Holmes, Chief Academic Officer, says, "It's amazing how well kids do at hitting targets when they know what it is. As said, clear goals or targets are helpful for educating students, but the new system does not provide a clear target. ACPS's new grading system fails to recognize between excellent achievement and average achievement. ACPS says a 3 is proficient, which means able to do something properly and skillfully. It's horrible that students who deserve a 4 achieve a 3. For example, if a student gets an honor roll from the old grading system, that student could just get a 3 from the new grading system, even though that student had perfectly understood the subject matter. In conclusion, the standards-based grading system is too confusing to teachers and students, has unfair scoring, and is unclear of how to achieve a 4. Since the standards-based grading system doesn't give out awards, it doesn't motivate the students to strive towards excellence.
Now that you've heard from each team and judged their presentation, take a minute or two to add suggestions or comments. Thank you for listening and participating in our debate. The results will be announced in January after the winter break.
Okay, so let's give both sides a hand because they did a really nice job.